Welcome to the video. Glad you could join us here. North Shore Satsang. Before we jump right into the subject matter, we're going to take some time to get ourselves centered, get ourselves focused, relaxed. And we're going to do this by just taking a look at the ocean without any commentary. So we're going to do that for a little while. And then we'll begin our little talk here, a little satsang here. All right. This video is courtesy of a WSP Skydiver on youtube.com, Creative Commons video. It's at the North Shore Bonsai Pipeline area of the North Shore of Oahu, Hawaii. Watching the sunset. We're out here in the breeze, beautiful breeze. Birds are chirping, chimes are ringing, insects are buzzing. It's a beautiful evening, and we're just grateful that we are here in such a time that the arrival of the wave of grace has actually touched upon these shores. Imagine for a moment the ocean, and there's a wave coming in. It's a wave of God's grace. It's a wave of multi-dimensionality, and this wave will affect all those who are on shore, sitting on shore, like we're doing right now virtually. And what it will do is it will open up the awareness to multi-dimensional functioning. And by doing this, it will enable those who've opened up to sidestep the troubles that the next wave that comes in will bring. See, there is this galactic super wave coming in through space, traveling through space towards us from the galactic center. And this galactic super wave is going to bring about drastic changes in the solar system. It's going to bring about drastic changes in the sun. The sun will rapidly turn into a red giant. It will expand, it will superheat, and that will melt down 3D Earth. And the basic plan is some will go down to lower vibration, some will go to a higher vibration. But there's an even better option than that, and some will go to multidimensional functioning, which is our natural state of functioning. So before this galactic superwave arrives and causes chaos on planet Earth, ahead of that wave is this wave of God's grace, multidimensionality. Somehow it's going to open up, enable us to open up, be aware of our natural state of functioning, which is multidimensional functioning. We call it, that's a term we give it. It's really infinite depth of experiencing, weaving an infinite tapestry of richness. All seamless, all flowing. We can make no wrong choices. Delightful, absolute delight. That's our natural state of functioning. And so those who open up to that will sidestep the troubles to come on this planet. We'll also sidestep lower and higher frequencies. There's no need to involve yourself in all of that at all. We have a 6-month window here. And the first pulse, the first breeze of multidimensionality reached these shores on July 5th. the morning of July 5th, I experienced the profound effect of this. And once anyone experiences this, they will look at what came before, 3D functioning as a joke. Just, you know, we lose all interest in understanding that there's no real richness at all in this world. We're madly pursuing it, pursuing like pursuing nothing, really. And so those who have experienced this multidimensionality may be feeling apathetic, may be feeling that they're not interested in the world anymore. They just sink their teeth into it. They can't get motivated. They can't get fired up. They don't see it as interesting anymore. That's okay. That's what one would expect. When you have a great, great experience of widening and seeing what your life is really about, then automatically you'll look back at what you did before and say, ah, that was nothing. What a waste of time that was. Just one second here. We're going to shift over to this. We're back. Just had an interruption there. I have something planned for that. I can always shift here. We have a little studio, outdoor studio, and I'm trying to get a little more sophisticated when I'm presenting here. And this is all done live. There's no pause button. But what I do is I'm able to shift over to the video without any audio, without any microphone audio, so I can talk to whoever wants to speak to me. And then when they're finished with that, then go back to the video. So it's really a fantastic situation. It gives you the opportunity to relax, process what's being said. What's being said is that there's a galactic superwave headed towards the solar system. We'll reach here on the shores of the solar system about the end of December 2012. But ahead of this galactic superwave is a wave of divine grace, which is going to open up our awareness to multidimensional focusing for those who want this, or those who are prepared for this, and enable us then to sidestep the troubles that the galactic superwave is going to bring here on planet Earth. And we don't even need to talk about that much, really. Our focus is in the great news, the great gospel, that this multidimensionality is now the breeze, the first breeze has reached here, has reached us, and we felt it. It's being registered. Those who are most sensitive are registering it. We say, hey, what happened? Suddenly I had this multidimensional experience. And I'll tell you this for sure. The next breeze is close behind. Really. I was shown all this, I don't know how long ago was it, maybe 6-7 years ago. How it would work. And how we would be in a situation of great despondency and feeling like the world is just intolerable. It's never going to get better. And feeling we just want to leave here. This is just ridiculous. We have no future here. Feeling miserable. And then suddenly this breeze comes in and we get the little pulses of breeze. And before you know it, it's a steady breeze, a beautiful steady breeze. And the steady breeze blows away all of that, those dark clouds. And leaves everything absolutely sparkling and clear and beautiful. Multidimensional. That's literally what's going to happen. And I've been all in on that scenario. And here we go. I got this intuitional insight that July 5th would be the day. And I put all my effort and intention into just getting to July 5th. I told those who wanted to know, hang in here. Hang in here till July 5th. Just hang on. Get to July 5th, and On that day, you're likely to experience something very unusual, very helpful. A great change is suddenly underway, and it is. It's tremendous. Multidimensional functioning is infinite depth, infinite delight, infinite safety, invulnerability. There's no such thing as a wrong choice, and seamless flowing of experience. Anyone who experiences this will look at what we've been engaged in as folly, because it has been folly. It's an attempt to create a separate reality. It's an attempt to come up with a fake multidimensional experience. It's a sham. It's a hoax. It's a con. We're trying to forget what we are and then pass off this ridiculous flatland experience we have here as something rich, something that's better than multidimensionality. Well, we will look back in hindsight at that and just laugh, really just laugh at that. Hilarious. Absolutely hilarious. What a funny joke. It'll be the funniest joke ever that we actually believed that this experience we're having now is somehow better than multidimensionality. And we wanted to be prime creators. We wanted to replace the prime creator. We wanted to create a new reality, a new creation. We wanted to be the origin, the creators of this new creation. So we have put up this ridiculous illusion so as a way of forgetting what we are, forgetting reality, and saying, this is real. This is better. This is what we want. Anything else is just a dream. We don't want that. And so we've been engaged in living in this extreme spiritual poverty. State of death, really. We've been in a death state. Flatline state. We're all flatliners here. All flatliners. And yet some of us are letting go of the flatliner. So my advice to you is to focus on letting go, releasing. Be in a state of complete releasing. An acceptance, and allowance to let go of the illusion. It's not a physical release or emotional release or anything like that. It's deeper than that. It's like dropping the flatline experience. Letting it go. Say adios, sayonara, auf Wiedersehen, au revoir, aloha. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go into the breeze. Let the breeze carry it away. Let this breeze of multidimensionality just softly carry away all our flatline pretensions as the nothing that they really were. There's nothing you want to hold on. There's nothing about that you want to value or hold on to. Let it go with a smile. And so when we feel apathetic, unmotivated, uninterested in the world, it's not depression right now. It's really we're in that mode now of letting it all go. Let this breeze of multidimensionality carry it away. That is the mantra of the times. Let it all go. Allow this breeze to wash it all away. And because these pulses of breeze will come more and more frequently until it's a steady stream. And then we will see rapidly, we will realize all of this gloom and doom and everything has been carried away from us out to sea. And we will feel like, we're coming back home. It'll be tremendous. We are here at the studios, just hanging out in this wonderful place, putting on this live satsang. and talking about what is the absolute news of the day. I'm telling you the news of the day. It's very interesting, isn't it, that on July 4th, late July 4th, I think, and then really coming into its own on July 5th was the news of the discovery of the, what is it, Higgs boson, or the God particle or something, and that just dominated the news, and it still is dominating the news, like the greatest scientific discovery ever. How interesting that on that same very day, this wave of divine grace touched the shores of this planet and began the process of awakening us to multidimensionality and freeing us from this ridiculous flatline experience. The discovery of the Higgs boson, the God particle, was a distraction, okay? It was an attempt to divert us and make us think, hey, this 3D flatline experience is could be really interesting. We can really do a lot of stuff with this discovery, etc. It's nothing. Okay, it has no relevance whatsoever. And yet, that was the big news. The really big news wasn't the Higgs boson, God particle discovery. It was that this cosmic wave of divine grace touch the shores of this planet. That is enormous news. It's the biggest news we've ever had on this planet. And I was fortunate enough to actually break this news here on this channel. I consider myself a real news reporter because this is real news. The other stuff, not of any importance or consequence whatsoever. Has no relevance to our functioning at all. Particles. What are particles? Particles are simply dream stuff. And we will rapidly realize this, that there's a reality beyond the world of particles and energy and nature and all of that. There's a living light. And we are that living light. And this living light is what we call multidimensional, but it's infinite depth to it. It can access the all, every moment. There's nothing that is off limits to it. It weaves tapestries effortlessly. We go on a magic carpet ride, a miraculous carpet ride, as it were, beyond anything that we can imagine. And all the trinkets of this world, the theme park, you know, amusements of this world, both seem like nothing but specks of dust. No interest there. So, we're riding the wave of real news here, and this is a real reportage here. Objective, real reporting. Coming to you from this beautiful outdoor studios in this incredible ambience with a background of the North Shore, one of the more, you know, just enjoy this North Shore. How beautiful is that? You can almost feel the multidimensionality of it, right? Depth, so many waves, so much going on there. And yet, multidimensionality, when you experience it, wow. You'll say, hey, now that's living. Now that's living. That's the reaction I had. So, wow, that now that's life. That's living. Stuff I've been doing before, poof, that's not living. That's not life. No way. That's fake life. That's trying to come up with something opposite of life. That's dying. That's deadness. It's anti-life. It's a forgetfulness of life. It's a charade. It's a pretense. It's delusion. It's an illusion. It's a whim. It's a false premise. False premise that we can change reality. We cannot change reality. We need to exchange the false premise for a true premise, which says we cannot change reality. I tell you this, the waves, these breezes of multidimensionality that will be coming in, the next one will be arriving soon. And our dreams will become different. Wake up in the morning and we say, what in the world was that? Wow. I mean, it's like the colors are more beautiful. Everything is more beautiful. There's something really vivid and real and alive and intense and incredible going on. And those may alternate with dreams that seem kind of odd. But we are in a time now. We are in a time, this unprecedented time, and so important to get to this time. We're at, what, July 6th now, I believe. Yeah? July 6th of Friday, 2012. And we are out deep into it. You know, we are now getting there. We're getting there. Just like we've all been told, right? Last part of 2012, that's when the magic carpet ride begins. Forget about drugs, okay? Very important. Forget about stimulants, coffee, drugs. Don't try to manufacture a multidimensional experience. The ego will keep trying to tell you to do that. The ego's whole thing is to tell you that you can have something that's just as good as a multidimensional experience here in this flatland, in this mirage. It'll tell you, oh, there's all sorts of ways to do it. Don't go for that anymore. Forget it. Nothing more than gaudy trinkets. It's like collecting pieces of dust. Don't go for the dust. Go for the real prize. Go for what we're entitled to. We're entitled to function the way that God created us to function. We're absolutely entitled to that. We're all pre-qualified to function the way we were created to function. We're all pre-qualified to experience eternal delight and richness, carefreeness. And that is arriving now. It's like putting fertilizer on the plant. Suddenly, interestingly enough, a couple days ago, I put some Miracle-Gro on my plants, which I usually never do. I never fertilize my plants, really, except for time release. But I decided, suddenly I said, you know what? I'm going to supercharge these plants. And I gave them this water full of, you know, this dissolved Miracle-Gro, and boom, hit them with that. And they like, hey, you know, boom, greened up, growing, fruit flowering. They're just supercharged. It's like that. It's like we're getting this supercharged big boost. The big boost is here now. We're on the crest of it. We're talking about it. We're reporting it. This is like a newscast. The big boost is here now. Maybe I should put on a newscast for everyone. It's not impossible. I could probably do it. And real news, folks, I've got good news for you. I have really great news for you. No more if it bleeds, it leads. No. We've got really great news. And that is, we are being supercharged now. And the fruits of that supercharging is multidimensional awareness. And I know these promises have been given out for a long time, but you know what? It's coming. The first wave has already arrived. The first band has already arrived. And just touch us gently, just very gently, enough to just have a very short but beautiful experience, but enough to say, holy cow, now that was really great. I want more of that. The next breeze will probably be a little stronger. And we don't have to panic and say we don't know what's going on. Because here we go. We know. We're listening to this and we're aware of what's taking place. It's not a big surprise at all. So I'm not exactly sure how I'm going to respond to this. Should I start a new channel, you know, and do like a newscast and have people tune in and like the 6 o'clock news. Yeah, it's possible, right? Possible. I don't know. Anything's possible. This product here, Ustream, is working right now. I'm able to do a bit of switching here, like this right here, and continue to somehow I'm getting it to work. Maybe we can just do that, because the best news of all time is arriving right now, and all this other stuff is just a distraction. It's not even worth paying attention to. I tell you what, you know, it's like all these little candles or cigarette lighters. We've been playing with those, you know, on the beach in the darkness, and then suddenly the dawn breaks. I mean, do we keep playing with our little candles and cigarette lighters like it's really cool, or would we say, whoa, wait a minute, what's this? What is that break in the horizon? Where's this? What is this light? Where's that coming from? Wow, you know, you say, oh, this is so much better. Oh my gosh, look at this light. It's, you know, it's, this experience is like that. Multi-dimensionality, the experiencing of it is like experiencing the sun compared to flat land, flatliner living. And 3D is like looking at a tiny little LED light, or a little flashlight, or LED light, or a candle, or, you know, a match. And thinking, wow, look at this little candle. Look at this candle I've got. It's really incredible. You know, look at this light. Whoa, I'm really cool. I'm so fortunate to have this. You know, this is it. And then suddenly the dawn comes. And everything, light is everywhere. You say, oh, that's the feeling. Multidimensionality is like that. It's like the dawn. And you don't even remember the sun, the light of the sun. You say, what is this? I thought this little candle was the only light I'd ever have. And I was trying to do so many things with this little candle. I was trying to worship this little candle. And now here's this dawn. And my gosh, everything is so beautiful. It's incredible. That's what it's like. But when we expect the dawn, we know it's there. We know it's coming. And then when we start to see it, we just say, ha, 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 oh, yeah. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. Here it comes. Here it comes, and we welcome it. And we let go. We just let go of all, everything that we had wrapped up around this little candle, this little LED light that we're pressing, thinking we're really fortunate to have this. All the things we have wrapped up around this, you know, we just say, ah, just let them relax, let them go. Don't need that anymore. We don't need all our bizarre rituals and beliefs and faiths and concepts and reactions and therapies and all that stuff. We don't need any of it anymore. Just let it all go. It's garbage. It's all wrapped up around a little LED light that we've been thinking is our source of light. Thinking, how can we adjust to this little LED light? How can we be more grateful to it? How can we, you know, live with this and live under this light and all this? And suddenly the sun comes up from below the horizon and whoa. Oh, what's that? Say, my gosh, I don't think we need this little LED light anymore, do we? We set it down. We set down all the rituals around it, all the constructs, all the belief system around it, all the songs, all the poetry, all the worship, everything we've wrapped up around it. We set it all down and say, okay, go in peace, but this isn't needed anymore. None of that stuff is needed anymore. We don't have to build castles of sin anymore. We don't have to try to make all these contrivances, believing that we have to somehow fit ourselves into these contrivances. We don't have to do that anymore. Here comes the sun. Here comes the dawning of the living light. Here comes multidimensionality. Here comes our true functioning. So let it come, let it be. This is tremendous. On the North Shore, just hanging out here with the North Shore ambience, North Shore vibe, which is a very multidimensional vibe. Nothing to do, nowhere to go, nothing to say. We don't need to deal with 3D anymore. That's the realization we're having, is that our imprisonment in 3D is over. And it's been an imprisonment. And it's been a sickness. Just prior to this multidimensional experience, I believe it was just prior, during my light sleep, I saw myself being committed to a terrible prison, and I saw my flesh rotting, and it was horrible. My flesh was just turning into like kind of a soft, cheesy, like cream cheese or something, you know, and there was horrible bubonic type of disturbances in the flesh, and all this terrible stuff, and I saw that, and then that was suddenly replaced by this multidimensional experience. So, and looking back from multidimensionality, well, I think when it first comes in, it highlights and puts things in proper perspective. And for a moment we see, oh my gosh, we've just been imprisoning ourselves in death. Horrible fleshy death. And we get that, and then comes the multidimensionality. We say, ah, this is life. This is what I tried to leave behind for this prison, terrible death-like condition and imprisonment. So I experienced that. Then last night I had some rough dreams about also how we suffer, how we've suffered, how we've treated ourselves, how the tricks we've played on ourselves to trap ourselves here, beat ourselves up, give ourselves this most terrible experience. And I expect the multidimensionality to come on strong. One of the theme songs I'm using is that coming on strong. Because really, it is now coming on strong. I don't know if I can even pull that up. I don't want to crash this session that we're having here, but let me see if I can pull up that song for you right now. Coming on strong. I'll go. Here we go. Pretty easy. Here. It's coming on. But what is coming on strong right now is the multidimensionality, which are not teardrops. But we may become aware of the situation that we have been in. Okay, so I want to alert you to this possibility. That's what I've been experiencing, is that when the light comes, living light comes, we start awakening to our true functionality. We realize that we've been imprisoned, that we've been through this horrible, horrible situation of pain, teardrops, heartaches. We've been gone a long, long time, as the song says, since you've gone. We've had nothing but heartaches. Since we've been gone from our true functioning, we've had nothing but heartache. And as the multidimensional wave of awakening comes on strong, we will realize, wow, we're leaving this terrible prison. And we may look back and look at that prison and say, oh my gosh, what did we do? What did we try to do to ourselves? How horrible was it? And yet, those who have worked on this are able to simply look at it and say, okay, and that's what I thought, that's what I knew, and now let's leave that behind, and now let's have multidimensionality come on strong for us, because that's what we're entitled to. That's our birthright, that's our inheritance, that's our functionality. And so we're just hanging out here with the North Shore as a background, with a little bit of music interlude there. Not in a hurry, not in a rush, not trying to prove anything. Look at that sun there, suddenly emerging there in the background. The light has come, it's breaking through the clouds. Living light will drive the clouds of death away, confusion. And I'll tell you this, when you let go, when you release it all your bad health, everything, your misery goes with it, because it was all part of the whole situation. The suffering you're having now is part of your attempt to forget what you are. And when you let go of that attempt, release it, it'll all go, all of it. You won't be feeling infirmity anymore. You'll be feeling refreshed. Multidimensionality brings a feeling of refreshment and delight. And no matter how sick you are right now, that's all the pack deal with what we've been through, you know, of the imprisonment, of the attempt to forget what we are. It's all part of that. It's all a scam. Some very interesting dynamics that I have noticed and have commented on from time to time. That is the belief that we can change what we are is hidden by the belief that we can heal what we are. That belief that we can heal and the desire to heal is essentially a statement that what we are got sick, right? And so it needs to be fixed, that what we are changed. It was attacked, it got sick, it was harmed. So we can fix the harm. So, which is a complete, total lie. That is the very basis of our delusion. So there are those who are in a position of pretending to help out those who've been beaten up, savaged. But I'll tell you this, the beating up and savagery of us symbolically was really brought about by those who want to heal. As strange as that may seem, the ones who seem to be the healers, the fixers, those who comfort us, the discomfort, let's say someone is set upon by a savage gang and they're beaten senseless, and then someone, part of the gang, is there and says, well, wait a minute, I'm going to stay here and I'm going to help this person get better and comfort them because I just don't like what happened. The fact is that one that stays and comforts, they're the ones who called the savage gang in there in the first place to beat you up, beat you senseless, so that then they could play the good, healing, comforting, helpful being. All the while, they're completely indulging in an egoic fantasy that what we are can be destroyed, and that they somehow, their primary, they can somehow put it back together again, because they have the power to put it back together again. As soon as you see multidimensional functioning, you'll see through this whole charade. All the tricks that we play, the victim, victimizer, all these things, the good guys, the bad guys, you'll see it's very different than what the world insists it is. There are so many here that they insist on sickness, they need people to suffer so they can help them. And help, by helping them, they're enforcing their delusion that what we are can be changed. That is a fact. And when we function multidimensionally, we suddenly see, we can't be sick. We're not sick. We don't need any healing. All sickness is part of the belief system that we can change what we are. All of it. When you let this go, gone with the wind. There's no more sickness. Sickness cannot be brought into multidimensionality. Cannot. Infirmity cannot be brought in there. Fatigue cannot be brought in there. Fear cannot be brought in there. That's all left behind is a package deal. The whole thing. So don't worry, don't say like, well, I'm penniless and I feel sick and depressed and getting old and all these things, blah, blah, blah. It doesn't make any difference. All that goes as a package deal. You will feel as if you're born again, born anew. Multidimensionality is the born again experience. People say it's not me anymore that lives in me, it's Christ that lives within me, meaning that's multidimensionality. It's my true functioning that lives within me. Now, it's a new life. It's actually the real life that's always been there. Let's take a break and just hang out at the North Shore for a while. Here comes the living light. Here comes the living light. What we've been waiting for. What we've been waiting for is now arriving. That is the good news. The arrival is here. We had to make it through to July 5th. A very tough go, wasn't it? I mean, I almost didn't make it. Couple days, like July 2nd, I was so depressed, I was scared, despondent, very despondent. And yet here we are. We made it. Congratulations to everyone, we made it. And along with that has come a slightly more sophisticated ability here to post these videos. The end result of a lot of stuff failing, a lot of stuff not working, crashing, etc. I had to find a workaround, and this actually is turning out even better than before. Richer witnessing here. And again, we're not in any specific hurry. We don't need to get anything done like a big project now. Our projects are over, okay? Now it's a time of simply experiencing this multidimensionality, starting to step into it. All our worldly projects are over. I worked like crazy to get all my projects finished. Have a beautiful garden, you know, beautiful flowers, landscaping, everything looks just like incredibly nice and beautiful. I said, I have to have this done by 4th of July. I said, everything has to be done before 4th of July. Very important. And wouldn't you know it, by the time 4th of July came, everything was done. We had a huge feast, and then the morning of July 5th, bingo. Multidimensionality arrives. That is the next big thing, okay? Experiencing this multidimensionality is the next big thing, and again, you absolutely cannot get it through drugs of any kind, of any way of manipulating the flesh or anything. No, that's not it. That's faking it. That's cheating yourself of it. That's following the ego's path. The ego's path is sex, drugs, and rock and roll. That's the ego's path. And you're cheating yourself of multidimensionality if you're engaging in any of that. Drop all of it. You don't need it. It's nothing. The next big thing is here. The big boost is here now. Wonder if I can pull up something along those lines. Let's take a North Shore break again, and I'll see if I can pull something up about the big boost. Alright, there it is. The big boost is here now. That's what these great teachers have been preparing us for. This wonderful breeze of multidimensionality. Let me pull down the audio. This is all being mixed live. pulling the threads together here. It's working out great. The big boost is here now. Just say, the big boost is here now. It's here now. It's arrived. This is the next big project. The other projects in the world aren't important. It's not important what happens in the world anymore. Whatever. It's unimportant. As soon as you get a taste of honey, you know, get a taste of multidimensionality, you realize whatever happens in the world is completely inconsequential. Doesn't matter at all. It's ridiculous to even think about it. A lot of people have been trying to fake multidimensionality. The various ways, there's all sorts of ways the ego will sponsor how to fake it. But when you get the real taste of it, you know, now this is not a fake. This is really something. This is really it. And you feel like, I've just gone live. I suddenly woke up from a dream of death. As long as we're in dreams of death, we'll fake multidimensionality and just to try to say, hey, isn't this great situation we're in? We don't miss home. We don't miss multidimensionality. We don't miss any of that because we've got all this great stuff. We've got the sex, the drugs, and the rock and roll. And we got all the fakery, all the ways to try and simulate multidimensionality. We got all the high tech, we can simulate it. You know, the attitude of those in the dreams of death is, who needs life? We can simulate it. We got all this technology, let's just work hard and we can fake it. Throw a bunch of special effects together and call it good. And then we get a taste of honey and we say, oh my gosh, What a waste of time I've been engaged in here. Wow, what a waste of time. And we realize we don't need to waste time anymore. Because here comes the sun, here comes the living light. And that's it. That's really it. And I'm making these videos, you know, I make them long. Why not? Because what else are we going to do with the evening? Think about it. Are we going to spend time watching some television show? I mean, right now there's a baseball game going on, which I usually would watch, but I don't need to watch it. This is better. We're sitting here watching the North Shore just flow. We're sitting here realizing that the big boost is here now. We're sitting here realizing we can let go of all of our charades. We don't need them anymore. And there will be those who will do this, absolutely. Some sooner than others. I don't know when I'll do it. I imagine some will do it sooner than me. Very possible. Even those who are listening right now, they might do it sooner. Might do it today. Just drop all the charades. No longer needed. Set down the candle when the sun has come. When dawn breaks, we set aside our weird rituals of night. And we don't even really remember. Don't need to realize we don't need to even remember them. They serve their purpose to keep us in a false state of belief and hope. But